beautiful Pisces friends, and welcome to your horoscope for November of 2020. We're Pisces this month. The pace of life gets to start picking back up. We get some real forward motion underneath our feet, and I think that that is something we have all kind of been waiting for here in 2020. So we can definitely start to expect to see that this month, as we have Mercury coming out of retrograde, Mars coming out of retrograde, your ruling planet Neptune will come out of retrograde, we've got our last lunar eclipse this month, Jupiter and Pluto coming together, a super moon. So it's kind of a busy month, but it's one that I think reeks of a delicious deep breath that we've been waiting for. So I can't wait to talk to you about what's coming for you this month. Now, before we get in there, the eat and greets are continuing on this month with beautiful friends coming over. Amari Martin will be here, Jezebel Sonal will be here, Mecca Woods, Demetrius Bagley, Matthew We Met, Judith Hill, Vanessa Montgomery will be here, Simon Vorster will be talking about intercepted signs. There is just so much going on here in November that I'm so grateful these friends continue to want to be here and share with us. So I hope you don't miss a minute of that. And if you'd like to watch the replay of the Eat and Greets, if you can't come live, you can watch them ad-free by joining me on Patreon. And that link is in the description box down below, okay? All right, Pisces, let's jump in and see what's going on. So right at the beginning of the month on the 3rd, we've got Mercury coming direct again in the energy of Libra. Now this is going to light up your 8th house space for you. So this is a lot about, I think, healing in relationships for you, or getting to the depth or the nitty gritty, having those deep conversations in your relationships, because Libra is about relationships. It is about balance. So where your intimate relationships are concerned, where your money is concerned, where your health or your therapy or even your connection to certain organizations is concerned, it's like, what's the depth? What's the proper alignment of our relationship at this particular time? And Mercury has already been here. He's already been through Libra. He's already been through 12 degrees of Scorpio as well. So this is nothing new that you're looking at. But now I think as he's direct, you feel a lot more comfortable making decisions or having those conversations in this particular arena of your life. So if there's also something going on with a spouse or a partner or a resource that you are connected with, you may hear information coming from that direction as well. On the 10th, we see that Mercury, who's now direct, moving forward into the energy of Scorpio. So pushing back up there into the 9th house space. And the 9th house is going to stay pretty busy, pretty energetic for you this month. So changes. You know, Mercury and Scorpio, like I said, has already been here up to 12 degrees. So I think you see a lot more forward motion when we get past the 12 degrees of Scorpio, since that's where Mercury went retrograde. So up until then, you're basically in this 9th house, publishing, marketing, broadcasting, education, travel, languages, things that have to do with the law. You're re-looking still at some of the things you've already seen and getting ready to make those adjustments. But more so than anything, I feel like Mercury in this position in Scorpio has allowed for some depth, like the depth of evaluation. You've been able to observe your emotions, your desires, your drives, your inter or codependence in certain situations in this area. You know, places that you feel passionately pulled or tugged, there maybe it feels like there's been a little power struggle here a little bit. And now Mercury, having come back through this area already, is showing you where you can make some decisions to have this area really be very, very healthy for yourself. I wouldn't be surprised if you were studying something or even studying with someone and you've had a course correction. You're like, I don't know that I really want to do this, or I don't want to do this way. So if you have students in your life as well, don't be surprised if there's a little turn of events that comes with that, okay? On the 12th, we see Jupiter and Pluto coming together. Jupiter being one of your traditional ruling planets, coming together again with Pluto. Now, we saw them come together 3 different times this year, April, June, and now. Now, as they came together in April, this is, we're beginning something. We were beginning something different. We're beginning something in your social life, in your organizational life, a new long-range plan. It has come into view. And I think it really kicked off in April. And then you readjusted what's happening in this long-range plan, or you felt like you had to hold back in making any decisions or moving anything forward. And now we're here at the end of the year. And I think there's a bit of a light at the end of the tunnel because it's come full circle. But what Jupiter and Pluto do as they come together is they supercharge you. They like superpower charge you, right? And they go, wait a minute, You're made of a lot more than you know of. You've got this immense inner strength and resource to help you efficiently and effectively tackle these challenges and what feels like these obstacles in your life in order to be successful and go towards what you actually want to create here. It's like that Sonic the Hedgehog. You know, as these guys come together, then things for the weeks after are like, it's moving very quickly. And you're just like, yeah, it's kind of the gangster energy. Like, I've got this, you know, I need to just put on some music and handle my business. So I think that this is a wonderful energy in this arena for you to see where are you really ready to take that stamina and that inner strength and create new structure for yourself in your life. On the 14th, we see Mars coming out of retrograde in the energy of Aries. Now, this is down in your second house. So as Mars has been retrograde, we've been looking over our desires, right? What do I desire in this particular area of my life? Do I still desire to make money this way? Do I still desire to do this with my budget? Do I still desire my possessions to look this way? But also, whether I do or I don't, whatever's happening with my money, whatever's happening with my self-esteem, whatever's happening with how I value myself, I got to get a strategy in place to take that thing forward, right? So we have also, with this Mars retrograde, been re-looking at your strategy around your second house happenings. And there's some identity attached to this as well. So as Mars comes direct here on the 14th, it is really time to step into those boots of that strategy and start walking that bad boy forward. Pisces, who did you decide you wanted to be as you were re-looking at the strategy? Because you want to come at it very assertively. Not aggressively, but assertively to make this area of your life happen. Did you figure out that, yeah, you can come up with 8 different passive streams of income to come into your life? Did you figure out that you want to take this creative talent that you have on the road and you're ready to come up and you're ready to start coming out and showcase who you are to us and take this on the road? You know, what is it that you found out here in the second house that you're ready to do and let this Mars take you to that greatness? Start that greatness, okay? On the 15th, we've got a new moon happening in Scorpio. So again, bringing more emphasis into this ninth house arena. So at the new moon, you want to plant your seeds of intention. If you have been wanting to study something, or you've been looking for that one-on-one mentor, you've needed an attorney, you're ready to put a legal situation to bed, immigration things are on your table. Maybe it's that you're trying to get that book out there. You're ready to put it out there. You want to start that YouTube channel. Whatever is allowing you to expand out more, including your faith, and what you believe and how you believe in things, right? I have this vision of you right now, Pisces, too. It's just like, I feel like you needed to do a lot this year with your physical body to take yourself to physically and somatically see yourself get out beyond the edge of your fingertips so you know that there's more out there. This moon will help you to be able to do that. So plant your seeds of intention and ask for help to begin that or to course correct or to adjust or to bring new life to this area of your life. Now, on the 21st, Venus is also going to come into Scorpio, so she's going to magnetize this area. So she's literally trying to pull benefits to this area for you. So are you getting some royalties from that book? Is that YouTube channel finally got enough subscribers? You can start make money off it. You know, are you going to need to pay out something in a court situation? Whatever it is, Venus is bringing that money and relational magnetizing to this area of your life so that you can have what you want here. You can have the benefits of this area, okay? Now, depending on how it's connecting in your chart too, I do want you to pay attention, Pisces, because this could be that as Venus comes into this area, you are having to make a relatively big payment. Now, if you're paying for school, or you're paying for class or something like that, that makes sense. But if it does happen to be something you didn't necessarily expect, I just want you to know this might be the time frame that you see that rolling in. As we also are on the 21st, we see the sun move into the energy of Sagittarius, bringing light, heat, life, and vitality, tip top of the chart. A lot of this being about career, about how you move in the world, what you're doing. Is it time to advance what you're doing? I also think too, because this is Sagittarian energy, this is like work-related travel. So even if that means that you're having to Zoom, you know, from Colorado to China, you know, and you're having, it's like the work-related travel bit is very much so alive and well with Sagittarian energy. But it too is about expanding you out, getting you out beyond your fingertips. This could also be that you take on teaching, or this is as much about broadcasting, you broadcasting or putting something out there, as it is just about the work. But the last thing I want to say is that I think Pisces, because there's so much of this come out of your shell, come out Pisces energy on you, and it really runs with you through 2021, this could also be that you are deciding to take a new name, whether that means you get married, you get divorced, you change your company name, you become an LLC. I mean, whatever it is, you could also be taking a new name that's far beyond your vision, and it takes you above your own horizon. Now, on the 29th, we've got your ruling planet Neptune coming out of retrograde, of course, in your sign. So I think that some of the retrograde time for you was about getting really solid on who you are, right? Like, not the daydreamy, none of that. And not that every Pisces is daydreamy, but for all of us, Neptune provides this daydreamy kind of place where we can go in between reality and fantasy, the dream and the reality, right? And as Neptune has been out of retrograde, things have been very concrete. So it was like, who am I? Do I fit my own ideal of my life, right? Are the things in my life, am I in alignment with them? Do they fit my ideals? And that's a very big question, because then what you have to answer to that, as Neptune is now out of retrograde, is can I now go towards it, right? If I figured out that yes, I do fit my own ideal, or no, I don't, now I've got to walk towards that, and I got to use that in between the world's energy to walk me forward. Because we can have these perfect visions of ourselves and want to be your higher self and be the change you want to see in the world, but if you're not doing anything about that, or we're not making any moves to get better or change direction, that's simply just not going to work. We're going to just be having the same conversation over and over and over again, right? So where are you prepared as Neptune, your ruling planet, comes out of retrograde to say, okay, I've seen it in the reality. I don't need to wonder if this is real or fake anymore. I just need to make some decisions, right? So I feel like this is a beautiful energy to help you be able to do that, which doesn't mean that you do that with all the bravery of like six troops. You know, sometimes we have to walk courageously and fearfully towards a new direction. So it could be definitely that for you. Now, as we close out this month, we've got a full moon lunar eclipse happening in the energy of Gemini, lighting up the fourth house space. So home gets a little temperamental. The people in your home maybe get a little temperamental, right? This is a lunar eclipse, and it is around Gemini energy. And this is also going to interact with your ruling planet, now out of retrograde. So this could be a very solid change to home for you. And this could also be, you know, that solid change to something going on with your parents or people you consider family, and they've got something going on, but this very much so is very real, and it impacts you and how you'll need to show up and interact with this. Now, the biggest thing I think about this particular eclipse is, even though it is still the full moon and says something has to be ended, acknowledged, and adjusted, in the energy of Gemini, this has a lot to do with the words that are coming out of your mouth, contracts that have been made, thinking and motivation that's on the table, learning. I just really see housing. This could definitely have to do with housing, not only like, where am I going to live? But maybe you got to literally sign another lease. Like, you're like, I'm moving. I'm living in the ice cap. I don't know. I got to get out of here. Whatever it is, though, it definitely seems to bring this element of communication and signing. There's a lot of details that goes into the communications around home in this next 6 months for you, Pisces, okay? All right, my beautiful Pisces fish, I look forward to seeing you all the way through November in the weekly videos, in the eat and greets. Hopefully you've watched your 2021, and just everywhere we can hang out. I look forward to walking and learning with you, okay? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you so much, and I'll see you next month. Bye, Pisces.